Hi guys, it's Bob back on board sailing vessel Talisman. So glad to be back on board. Today I'm actually undertaking a two-week journey up the east coast of Australia from Ballina to the start of the Barrier Reef, the Great Keppel group of islands near Yeppoon. So it's probably about 1,000 kilometres, and I'm just going to take my time and probably get up there in around about 2 weeks. So I left Ballina Bar probably about an hour ago. The sun's about to set. Probably 3 hours or so I'll be at Julian Rocks, where I plan to spend the night. I'll arrive in dark, but I know my way around there, so should I be fine. And yeah, the autopilot's doing a good work at the helm there. Another yacht was heading south towards Sydney, just past us by, and the sun's setting. I'll give you a quick look. Beam of Duramba Beach, and beautiful day sailing. Unfortunately, last night when I was pulling the main down, I got a bit of a tear in the sail. So pretty sure it's not the end of the trip, but I should be able to fix it, and hopefully it'll get me there. I've got some of this heavy duty sail repair tape. I've never used it, but hopefully it'll do the job. I'm pretty confident. So yeah, we'll give it a crack. That's the northern tip of Moreton Island. We're coming through the east passage, and we've just kind of dropped off the tip of the island, and there's a couple of shoaling banks you've got to be careful for, but there's a few port markers and a starboard marker, so pretty straightforward navigation. Just saw a baby turtle in the ocean, and it's a magical day. Getting pushed along about 7 knots. Just motor sailing. Unfortunately, there's no breeze, but very, very enjoyable morning. Hey guys, it's day four. The sun's about to set. I'm just off Noosa. I stayed last night at a place called Big Sand Hills at the south end of Moreton Island, and I've done about 57 miles today so far. I've got another 30 odd to do to get to Double Island Point, which is where I'm staying tonight, so that I can get the 8 a.m. High tide going through the Wide Bay Bar in the morning. And yeah, the sun's about to set. According to the Navionics program, I should be there at about 11 p.m. or thereabouts, and I'll just drop anchor on the inside of Rainbow Bay. There's a light nor'easter, So it shouldn't be a bit rolly, but not too uncomfortable. I was going to pull in at Malula Bar, but the forecast is better to go through the bay tomorrow rather than attack the bar in a couple of days' time. It's looking pretty windy. Just coming through the Inskip Point, Sandy Bay, Wide Bay Bar, and it's quite a mild day today. There's not a lot of swell, probably a metre of swell. We've got four boats coming back out to sea, and just my lonesome heading in. Gary's Anchorage this morning and made my way up through the Sandy Straits, and it was an awesome trip. I kind of benefited from the tide, obviously, and went along at 6 to 7 knots, made a lot of progress, and now I'm probably about 10 miles south of Wathumba Creek. I've never been there before. In fact, I've never sailed up the west coast of Fraser, but it's just a beautiful place. Got a nice anchorage for the night, sun setting, beer's cold. And I'll give you a quick look around. Stunning. It's coming into Wathumba Creek. It's about an hour and a half after high tide, so it's been varying from 1.4 to about 2.2 metres. And I think I've just got to make it around. There's no leads whatsoever. There's supposedly a red port marker, but nowhere to be seen. But you can see the deep water, or deeper water. But it's on an angle back towards the north end of Fraser Island. So I think this is the deeper channel through here. So far, so good. Paper and waiting for low tide to see if I bottom out or not, and I heard a bang and I think a fish has just jumped into the dinghy. Let's go check it out. Oh, it's a mullet. Right on low tide, definitely not a spot to be navigated at low tide. It pretty much dries out. I'll give you a quick look around.